We have gathered here today in front of the Israeli consulate in New York City in a show of solidarity with our brothers in the Holy Land who are currently being targeted and persecuted by the Israeli police. In recent days, the anti-Zionist Jewish community of Jerusalem has been suffering under the persecution of the Israeli government. The Israeli police have begun carrying out night raids on private homes, brutally attacking activists, waking up elderly people and children, and sowing fear with midnight arrests. Over the last 2 weeks, they have arrested about a dozen anti-Zionist Jews. When the neighbors protest against these arrests, the police attack them too with brutality and stun grenades. Community leaders say that this reign of terror is clearly aimed at breaking the resolve of the anti-Zionist community and denying them their internationally recognized freedom of speech. For decades, the anti-Zionist community have opposed and fought against the existence of the State of Israel and against its anti-religious oppression, the occupation of the Holy Land, and all of the criminal acts. Religious Jews have faithfully adhered to Judaism throughout the generations, keeping its commandments and believing in the fundamental principles of the Torah, one of which is that Jews are in exile and we are forbidden to take over the Holy Land by force. The Zionists, from their founding day, have tried to uproot Judaism. They have attempted to transfer Judaism from religion into nationalism by calling the state a Jewish state and redefining basic Jewish concepts in terms of their movement. Furthermore, they have worked systematically for decades to lead the masses away from religious observance, sometimes by force and other times using more cunning methods. They do all in their ability to silence the voice of opposition. People think that Israelis fight only against their non-Jewish neighbors, but the truth is that they also fight the religious anti-Zionist Jews, and in fact, they consider them a much more dangerous enemy. Mossad Chief Yossi Cohen said, "The state has two central concerns, the fear of Iranian nuclear bomb and the Orthodox Jewish community." The former Mossad chief Ephraim Halevi even said about the Orthodox threat, "This danger is the most serious danger to the future of the state, far more than a nuclear Iran." Yes, we are a threat to them because we clarify to the world that they are an anti-Jewish movement, that they don't represent Judaism or world Jewry, and their activities are not condoned by the Torah. We delegitimize their right to be called a Jewish and undermine their claim of rights to the land. That is why they treat the anti-Zionist Jews with unheard of cruelty. Their only crime is that they have the courage to speak out against the shameful state of Israel. Therefore, We stand in solidarity with our brothers in the Holy Land. They are our representatives in fighting against the Zionist regime. We are proud of our brothers who have been resisting the Zionists for so long. We call out to them, keep strong. The Almighty is with you. Don't give up. And to the world we cry out, please do everything in your ability to stop the Israeli government reign of persecution against of all people who speak up against it. Let the world recognize the current brutality for what it is, just another link in the long chain of bloodshed. At this opportunity, we also like to express our outrage at the Zionist settlers who profess to be religious and thereby blurring the boundaries between Judaism and Zionism, who recently marched in the streets to attack our Arab neighbors. These people misrepresent Judaism in the worst way. The anti-Zionist Rabbinat of Jerusalem, the Idat Raidis, representing over 100,000 members throughout the Holy Land, last week issued a statement condemning these hooligans. We conclude with a prayer for the day when people in all countries will be able to live in peace without fear of being attacked for their religious belief. May the Almighty hear our cries and alleviate all their sufferings. May we merit to see soon the end of the Zionism, when all people will serve one God in peace and harmony. Amen.